Shalom, speaking to you, Gershon Salomon from Jerusalem, Israel, the founder and the chairman of the Temple Mount, a Land of Israel faithful movement. And we are going now to present you an excited event that we made last Passover 2014, when we renewed an exciting event, more than this, commandment of God to the people of Israel to bring the first barley harvest from the fields of Israel on Pesach, Passover, the Jewish pilgrimage holiday, to bring it as an offering to the God of Israel and to how can I say, to sacrifice it or to give it as an offering to the God of Israel. The first part of the barley, before the Israelites are using it, bring it to the God of Israel, that gives his blessings and his love and everything in the life of Israel. So the Temple Mount, the Land of Israel faithful movement, went on the 16th of April, the day that we should cut the first barley, and we cut it in one of the fields of the area of Judea in Israel, together with our two wonderful friends from America. And it was really an exciting event, you know, to renew after 2,000 years of destruction, to renew this event, this commandment, this request of God, the God of Israel. So we cut it, and in the same moment we dedicated it to be the Omer and to bring it to Jerusalem. And we brought it to Jaffa Gate, the main gate on the way to the Temple Mount in the biblical Jerusalem. And from this place, we marched. Our friend, this wonderful lady, was dressed with white dresses, like the ancient Israelis in the time of the temple, when they brought the offering of the Omer to the temple. And we marched all the way to the Temple Mount, and along the way many Israelis that came to make pilgrimage at this day, many, many thousands of them came, and along the way when they saw us, they were so excited and clapped hands to us, encouraged us to continue our holy work to rebuild the temple of God, the third temple, and to renew the life of Israel as in the biblical times, and to fulfill the mission of God to be a holy nation, a kingdom of priests, and a light to the nations. When we came to the Temple Mount area, We could not bring it inside the Temple Mount. So we brought it very close to the gates of the Temple Mount, dedicated it to the God of Israel. We thanked him for the privilege that he gave us to do so. And then we shared it with the people, the Israelites that came to pilgrimage, Jerusalem and the Temple Mount, to take it to their home, keep it as a memorial of the Omer event of 2014, and keep it for 2015 when we pray and act and fight and campaigning for the third temple of God of the people of Israel will be already built on Passover, Pesach 2015. Then, like the prophet Isaiah prophesied, people will come from all the world to the temple of God, to the house of God, to the God of Jacob, to learn his ways. And Torah will go from Jerusalem to all the world, and the word of God from Jerusalem. And then will come a real peace to all the world. Such a wonderful vision that the Temple Mount, the land of Israel, faithful movement, made on this Pesach. Another important step to make it a reality in the lifetime of all of us in Israel and all over the world. Shalom, and may the God of Israel bless all of you. Now, please look, take a look, an exciting look on the video that will show you what we did on this godly, special event. God bless you. Shalom.
He came today to this wonderful field to cut the first fruits of the barley. And as God commanded us and asked us to take it, to cut it today, this is the right day to do it, to cut, to take it to Jerusalem and then to bring it to the Temple Mount, to give it to God as an offering to God, the first fruits of the barley, not for people. The first fruits will go to God as an offering. And this was brought in the biblical times when the temple existed. It was brought to the Temple Mount, to the temple, okay? And the priest used to take it up and put it like this on the altar. And on the altar it was burned, you know? And everything for the glory and the holy of God.
Amen.
And we are now in time of spring in Israel. This is the holiday of Pesach, Passover. And yesterday, actually, was the first day of this great holiday. This holiday indicates freedom of the Jewish people, of the Israeli nation, from slavery in Egypt to freedom in the promised land of Israel that God gave them forever.
Yes.
2 days before, we had to make the Passover sacrifice, which indicates, you know, the becoming. Which indicates that God, when he came to punish the Egyptians because they did not want to allow the Israelites to go out from slavery, so God in the night, you know, passed on all the houses of the Egyptians, including the palace of the king, the Pharaoh, and punished them terribly. When he punished the firstborn sons of all the Egyptians. But he, as we say in Hebrew, Pasach, which means when he came to a Jewish house, what? He crossed over. And he did not touch, he just blessed this house. And he said to the Jews to put a sign of blood on the doors of the Jews, so he will know which house is Jewish in Egypt. And he crossed over these houses and just punished the houses of the Egyptians, the firstborn sons of them. And this is the reason that this holiday is called Pesach. Pesach in Hebrew means cross over. God crossed over the Jewish houses. So Monday afternoon, we had to make a Passover sacrifice. Yes, Passover sacrifice indicates also this great event of freedom that God saved the Israeli people from slavery in Egypt to freedom and the exodus to the promised land. So this is actually a family sacrifice. You know, every family in the biblical times when the temple existed, they used to bring the Passover sacrifice, a lamb. And it was sacrificed on the altar, and then they took the meat of the lamb and made a Seder Pesach. They had to eat it until 12 o'clock night. Okay, not 1 minute later. And thank to God about the miracles that he made to the Israelis in Egypt, and how he took them from Egypt to Israel. So this sacrifice, maybe it is the most important sacrifice that the Israelites did in the temple, because this sacrifice signs the great event that the God of Israel saved the Jewish people from, together with Moses, from slavery to freedom, the Holy Land. And near Sinai, it indicates also the becoming of the Jewish people, the Israeli nation, a nation from 12 tribes, one nation. The children of Israel, the people of the God of Israel. So this is the meaning of the Passover sacrifice. Unfortunately, we could not do it this time, this year, because the temple is still not rebuilt. But even when the temple is not rebuilt, this sacrifice can be made on the Temple Mount, not in any other place, on the Temple Mount, on an altar that the Israelis should build. Even when the temple is still not rebuilt. But again, because of, you know, the pressure that comes from all the world on Israel today, and and especially from the Arab countries, you know, and our leadership is doing a terrible mistake when they are, I would say, they fear human being, flesh and blood, and they don't trust enough on the God of Israel. Say to them, you will come to the land, build it, settle it, make it again the kingdom of your God and your kingdom, and build the temple and sacrifice the Passover sacrifice, all the other sacrifices as well. Again, weakness of our leadership. They fear human being and not the God of Israel. And God, we came here to cut this belly and to bring it to you for your honor, for your glory, as an offering that we bring from our deep heart. And you see these wonderful fields, it grows up in the great, wonderful, beautiful country that you gave us, the land of Israel, the promised land. So thank you, God, for giving us this privilege to bring you this offering of the first fruits of the barley. And we shall pray that next year, and we shall do for this with all our strength, to build your temple, your house, and next year to bring again this barley as an offering to you, God, but in the same time, the Passover sacrifice. We shall make pilgrimage of millions of Jews, Israelis, and people from the nations, exactly as the prophet Isaiah prophesied, with joy to come to your house. And thank you that you gave us the privilege to be your servants, to honor you, to worship you, to love you. Thank you, God, the God of Israel.